zeros of a polynomial. What is zeros of a polynomial? For any value of x, if this polynomial becomes zero, we call it as a zero of that polynomial. If I put 1 in the place of x, if I put 1, I get a 4. If you just compute it, you get a 4. So 1 is not a 0. 1 is not a 0. But if I put x equal to 1, means x equal to 0, sorry. X equal to 1 is not a 0. If I put x equal to 0, I get minus 2. 0 is also not the 0 of a polynomial. Let us find out putting x equal to minus 1. See, I'll take you with an example. We have a proper example with that. So, this one, 5x square minus 3x plus 7. We have to find which value of this at x equal to 1. What is the value of this? Let us see. We have to put x equal to 1 here. X equal to 1, 1, 1. 1 square is 1. 3 into 1 is 1. 7. You add this, you get 1. This is the value at x equal to 1. How about y equal to 2 for this value? Just put y equal to 2 here. 2 cube, 2. And you just have to multiply, you get this one. How about t equal to a? Just put t equal to a here. What do you get? This now, this value. So px equal to x minus 1, as I said, the 0 of this number, if I put x equal to 1, 1 minus 1 will be 0. So 0 of this expression, algebraic expression, or you can say a monomial, is 0. So p1 equal to 0, which any number which makes this expression as 0 is called the 0 of that polynomial. So in this case, 1 is a polynomial. If I write x minus 2, I put 2, 2 minus 2 is 0, so 2 is the 0 of that polynomial. I hope you got the idea. Also, if x minus 1 equal to 0, if I put x minus 1 equal to 0, say here, x will be equal to 1. This x equal to 1 is known as the root of that polynomial. X equal to 1 is the root of polynomial. If I write just x minus 2 equal to 0, x will be equal to 2. So x equal to 2 is the root of this polynomial. Okay. Now just consider a constant polynomial 5. Can you say what is the 0? It has no 0. Because this is a constant, there is no x to put some value to make it 0. A constant number cannot be a 0. So a non-zero constant polynomial like this has no 0. A non-zero constant polynomial has no 0. How about the zeros of a 0 polynomial? Every real number is a 0 of the 0 polynomial. 0 polynomial means 0. So every real number is a, you put any value. So every real number is a 0 of 0 polynomial. We have to check whether minus 2 and 2 are zeros of this polynomial. Put minus 2 here, put 2 here. Let us find out whether this expression becomes 0 or not. If you put 2, we get 4. If you put minus 2, you get 0. So minus 2 is the 0 of this expression x plus 2. Find the 0 of the polynomial 2x plus 1. So how to find out? Just put it as 0. 2x will be equal to minus 1. X will be equal to minus half. X equal to minus half is the 0 of this polynomial. Okay. So for any expression, linear expression like this, if you want to find the 0, just put ax plus b equal to 0. You will get the x. X will be equal to, say, minus b by a in this case. And this will be equal to 0. See, ax plus equal to 0. B will come here, minus b. X will be minus b by a. So, x equal to minus b by a is the 0. So, a linear polynomial has only one and only one 0. Linear polynomial, because it is only x to the power 1. Right? So, we can say that 0 of x minus 1 is 1. Minus 2 is the x is 0 of x plus 2, because minus 2 plus 2 equal to 0. So minus 2 is the 0 of this. We have to verify whether 2 and 0 are zeros of x square minus 2x or not. Let us put 2 here, 2 square minus 2 into 2, that is 0. And again put 0, 0 square minus 2 into 0 is 0. So both are the zeros of this polynomial. So what we got? In the linear polynomial, we got only one 0. But here this is not linear, this is binomial, you can say quadratic. So what we observe in this case is the 0 of polynomial need not be 0. 0 may be a 0 of a polynomial as we just saw, and every linear polynomial has one and only one 0, but a polynomial can have more than one 0. A linear polynomial, only 1, 0, but a polynomial like this term, which is actually a binomial, can have more than 1, 0.